Friends, welcome back to my channel. I received this RYWB116 light. It is from REYAX technology. This Wi-Fi Bluetooth multi-protocol module which allows to connect over Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. We can connect any Wi-Fi device to this device and then we can access to any internet protocol. In first step we will configure it using AT commands. For that purpose we need USB to TTL module. It is PL2303 USB to TTL module. This module, it is 3.3 volt operated. So from the module we have 5 volt and this side we have 3.3 volt. I will apply 3.3 volt to the first pin here. That is V battery. If you hold this module here, the first pin, that is V battery. Then there is reset pin. This time we will not use reset pin. The next pin here, that is RXD. RXD pin will go to TXD of this module. So this pin, it is TXD. It will go to RXD pin. We will leave reset pin blank. And then there is RXD pin of this USB to TTL module. It will go to TXD. Then there is wake up. We are not using wake up now, and ground will connect it to ground. V battery to 3.3 volt, 3V3, reset blank, RXD to TXD. TXD pin of this module is going to RXD, ground to ground. Let's connect to the USB port. If you have any problem in configuring this module, you can check the video. The video number is displayed on the screen. And let's see the REYAX. It is providing NFC, RFID products, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, long range, LoRa series, and GPS. It is providing a variety of components, variety of modules, and small in size, best in quality, low power consumption devices, long range and reliable. To use this module, to program this module, we need HTerm. HTerm is a software that produces USB to RS232 port serial communication. It provides ASCII, hexadecimal, binary and decimal input and output facility. It works like a simple hyperterminal. And then we need a third party software, Hercules setup. These two softwares, I will give the links in the video description. And to program this module, there is a very detailed documentation about this module. It is RYWB116. It is programming reference guide for this module. It is 199 pages. And the second one, that is 153 pages. So you can study it. You can program this module as per your requirement. You can control, you can command different parameters, different ports are provided. It is really a wonderful product. You can study these documents, but this time as a quick reference, I am showing a blog here. That is Michael Schoeffler. He wrote this blog in amazing style. We will copy this command set from here. So here is a quick reference command set. So this blogger did a very wonderful job. Really, I am thankful. You can take a very detailed and step-by-step guideline from this blog. How to do, how to work, how you can configure it. It is discussed in very deep details. Really, I am thankful for sharing such valuable information. I copied this content and new text document. Paste here. Now what to do? Just only save as text document dot HTS. Just only give the extension here, HTS, save. This is new document dot HTS. Now we will open this HTerm. It detected COM port 5. In the top row it is saying connect. Here is USB port, COM port, that is COM 5. It is automatically selected. If we have some other device, it will show the second device, but this time we are working in COM port 5. Baud rate 115200, that is standard baud rate for this module. And we will say parity control none and CTS flow control unchecked, stop bit 1 and data bit 8. We will connect. In this bottom it is saying connected to COM port 5, baud rate this, and these are the serial port communication parameters. Just only new line put here, CRLF. Now load file. In the desktop where we stored this file, and here all files. Now when we will select HTS, it will synchronize with this command open. Now we will start with one sequence, send, right click and send. It is showing U, and if you are seeing in hex format it will say 1C, and then baud rate detection end, send. Now it is welcome message, welcome to red point signals, and here is a complete parameters options. So we will select this first option, send. After that initialize, send. If there is some error, send again. Then initialize bandwidth, okay. There must be OK message. After each command we will receive OK message. If we see some error, send the same message again. Next command, initialization, OK. Then IP configuration, send. We can see here in ASCII command it is showing this is MAC address, and here is 192.168.50.1, which is discussed in the command line. Here in this command structures, the author have defined the IP address, subnet mask and gateway. If we give some valid gateway to internet, we can connect to internet as well. Then access point, send. Now access point is established. The Wi-Fi name is REYAX, and now if we will check Wi-Fi, we can connect our, we will connect our mobile phone using this password 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Now start access point. This is the access point definition, and this one is starting. So it started the REYAX wireless network and start server, send. All messages are OK. Now I will turn on the Wi-Fi. So here is REYAX module. REYAX connect 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Just only connect. We can see in the display it is showing AT plus RSI client connected. It is showing this network don't have network access connect anyway. Yes, connect. Now it is connected to this network. Okay, same way we can connect the second laptop here. I will connect my laptop. The same network we created REYAX, and we can see in this laptop REYAX is visible. Connect. It is asking for password 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Next. Because this time we are not connecting to the internet. And we can see here it is showing that RSI client connected. Now, okay, let me connect to the internet. In the web address, if I will give 192.168.50.1:5001, that is the port address. And now when I will hit enter, we can see here it is displaying some message that we accessed that this page is accessing through this Wi-Fi module. Now it is showing the data that we are accessing, and we are accessing through the Google Windows NT 10 64x64 bit. I will open the third party software, that is Hercules 3.2.8 run. It is here. Here we can see we have TCP client. The same address here, 192.168.50.1, that is in this command string, 192.168.50.1. This is the address, and here is the port 5001. So we are giving 192.168.50.1 and 5001 connect. Connecting to this, and it is connected. And now we can see, can we communicate to, now we will write some data, some command from here, from this Hercules. Hello. And we will see if it will send some data, it will send from here. Send. Yes, AT plus RSI read hello. It sends some data and then it read back from this module. So in this way we can access to the internet, and same way if we will access another time from the computer. Yes. Now I will enter again. We can see it is responding. So we can configure to our internet protocol, because this time we are not giving the gateway here. And if you provide some IP internet protocol mask and gateway, we can connect to internet. We will try in upcoming videos. Disconnect, and the from same from this module we can also connect to the serial port as well. If we disconnect from HTerm, we can open here. Yes, serial port COM5 opened. 1C sent Yes, it is sending data. Close. I will provide the links of these softwares and documents and this product, and we will see this product in upcoming videos. Maybe we can build some useful projects from this one. I hope you enjoyed this video. If it is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.